Yep, I bought that mask too. Hello, Asta here, and welcome back to my channel. So I've been to Thailand for 3 weeks for holidays, and it's been the worst holidays ever. Long story short, we had a scooter accident and I was pretty much bedbound for 2.5 weeks. So we couldn't explore Thailand anymore, but I managed to crawl to a local shopping center, to a makeup shops, and get some makeup. So today I just want to show you what I got, what Thai brands I've purchased, and if you want to see my mini haul, just keep on watching. As you probably know, Thailand is quite a cheap country to travel to. Also, products that they sell as well, especially the Thai made, are quite cheap. So first thing, I got this vitamin C cream by Lansley Cosmetics. This is quite a big brand name in Thailand. Pretty much all of their skincare products contains something that would brighten up your skin, because Asian girls over there are obsessed with the white, bright, light skin, opposite to what we like here in Europe and probably America, all tanned and nice and dark. This vitamin C cream brightens and whitens, probably because of the vitamin C in it. Also, by the same brand, I got this eye cream, and it says that it's anti-wrinkle eye gel, and it contains 99.99 gold in it. For €4, it contains gold? Highly doubt it. Okay, so then I'll start with the eyes. For the eyes, I got a nice little palette from Savannah Colors, and it's the Velvet Eyeshadow Palette. I just was so surprised how soft and velvety that is to the touch, like to the finger, and they're absolutely so creamy and pigmented. However, when I went to try it on my eyes, brushes didn't really pick up the color, so I ended up just using my finger to apply different colors from this palette on my eyes. This is what I'm wearing now as well. On the side note as well, all the eyeshadow palettes that the Thai brands have are so gorgeous. They're so soft to the touch, they're so creamy, and there's so many dupes for the very well-known brands that we have here, like Huda Beauty and Anastasia Beverly Hills. Literally same colors, and the actual quality looked amazing when I touched it with my fingers. Okay, the next one that I got is not the Thai brand. You probably know Natasha Denona. Yeah, there was a Sephora shop in Bangkok, so I went in to have a look. I really was hoping to get the Tatcha primer, but they don't stock it in stores, just online, so I didn't get it. But I end up getting this little mini glam palette. The reason why I got this one in particular, because of the cool tones in it. I have so many warm tone palettes, so I just thought I'll try this one. And I have her other ones, and I absolutely love the quality and the eyeshadow, so I thought I'm gonna pick this one up. Also, while we're talking about Sephora, I actually got this new primer from Laura Mercier. It's the Pure Canvas Primer, and it's the blurring one. I did get the small size because primers are so hard to find. Like for me, I end up buying full bottles and they don't work, and then they just sit there. So I just didn't want to waste more money before I try it. So I love Sephora for that they stock little mini sizes of different products, so you can really try it out and decide if you want to buy it. The first time I tried it, I wasn't very happy with it. It does blur your skin out when you apply it on a bare skin, but then when I went to apply foundation on top, it starts like peeling, and my skin looked like it's flaking, and this primer started moving around. So I don't know, maybe it might be to do with the fact that I am a little bit dehydrated around my T-zone, and I just have a dry skin there, and it's not sitting there properly. But I will have to try this product a few more times before I decide whether I like it or not. But first impressions weren't good, my skin didn't look well. So another thing that I got is this Gina McRae brand curler. I've read amazing reviews about this brand, and also about this curler specifically. I haven't used it yet because I have my eyelash extensions on. I didn't want to ruin them. So I'm so excited to try it out when I'll take the extensions off. Also, talking about Gina McRae, it was highly compared to MAC in terms of quality. So I did pick up beautiful powder from this brand. And I have to say, super creamy, super velvety to the touch. And it's actually a powder foundation which gives you flawless coverage and velvet finish. and I didn't get any liquid foundations because I was struggling to find the correct shade for myself. Obviously, Asian girls are more tanned. I just ended up getting this one and I'm absolutely loving the results. It made my skin look really smooth and it evened out my skin tone. I think the color match is pretty good as well compared to how dark the other shades were, so I'm definitely gonna use this powder for my everyday makeup. So talking about the powders, I also got this translucent setting powder from Sri Chand, if I pronounce it correctly. It's actually made in Thailand. It's one of their best sellers because it's so humid in Thailand and girls are really struggling to keep the makeup on. And this product is supposed to be amazing for setting your makeup and your makeup wouldn't move. So I did get this in a bigger jar. It's a translucent powder. It's actually lovely and very finely milled. Although rather than being white color, it has a little yellowy tint to it. But when I went in to apply it, it actually didn't leave any yellow residue or anything like that. And it's actually very comfortable on the skin as well. I've also got this mascara from the company called Mistine. Mistine is the biggest makeup company in Thailand. It's the Thai company. It has loads of just Mistine shops on its own throughout different shopping centers. I haven't tried this mascara yet just because I have another two that I'm using and I just don't want to open it and then it's just gonna just go to waste because I won't be able to use the three at the same time, but I'm very excited to try that. Also from Mistine, I got this black liquid liner. It's super easy to use it and you have a great control over it. So far really liking it and definitely gonna keep using that. Also I got another liner from Adobo company, again Thai brand. I love the felt tip. It's so easy to use again. If you just want to do a very thin line on the top lash line, it just applies effortlessly. So super happy with this purchase, already using it every day. Another thing that I got is this blusher from Sivana Colors. It's a beautiful little palette that contains the matte and the shimmery blush, and I'm wearing it now as well. It will be nice for my everyday use. Another unusual thing that I got is these eyelid tape things. So you know the way Asian girls mostly have the monolid, so they use these little tapes to apply it in their crease to create like a bigger crease. So I was very intrigued, I really wanted to try it. This is how it looks. It comes in a little box and there's loads of eye crease shaped little tapes. And I was trying to apply it and I was really struggling, so I really have to practice to figure it out how to use them, but they seem very cool, so I really wanted to try those. Also found some beauty blenders and I'm pretty sure they might be fake, but they felt so real because I have original beauty blenders and I touched these, I opened them and I was like, oh my god, is that original? Like, you see the way the packaging, it has all these like you wouldn't even tell it's a fake. I'm not sure if it's a fake, but you know what? The price is like €2. And I was like, can it be right? Can it be just only €2 for a beauty blender, which is like €18 here? So yeah, I just picked up two just to, you know, why not? I got quite a few brow pencils as well. Now in Thailand, each makeup shop I went into, there was such a good selection of brow products. Obviously, it seems like the Asian girls are obsessed with the brows as well as we are here in Europe and America. So there's loads of different brands with different pencils and pomades and you just name it. Like, there's so many. I did a little research and I found that this brand here, which called Cross Looks, are pretty amazing. So I picked up three different colors and I have to say they're so nice, so similar to the MAC ones that I use on myself and my clients. Another one that I got from the brand called Melissa Kiss. It's a 3-in-1 brow product. So you have actual pencil, which is a nice and wee bit bigger than the previous one I showed you. Also you have the spoolie and you have like a little powder thing that you can powder your brows in with. So this is also very nice. I used it a few times, love it. It's actually so creamy to apply and blends out lovely with the spoolie. So delighted with my brow products. I'll be sorted now for some time. So lastly for the lips, I got this Baby Bright Baobab Comfort Moist Lipstick. This is the lightest shade. I was struggling to find a good shade for the lipsticks because again, complexion is darker for Asian girls and they just make darker lipsticks obviously. So this was the lightest one. It's nice as a lip stain, it's nice and comfortable, really moisturizing. And another lipstick that I got, it's called Into It brand. This brand was compared to Kylie Cosmetic brands regarding their matte liquid lipsticks. In their collection, this is the lightest color. On me, it looks extremely orange, but I have to say it feels absolutely comfortable on the lips. So yeah, that's pretty much it, what I got. I hope you enjoyed my little haul of products and thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next video next week.